All right, folks, my next guest has been on fire. The ER30TR index up 24% year to date. Give you some context, the Russell 1000, that's a growth up just 11%. But now she's making some major moves, so let's bring in ERShares COO, Eva Anos. Eva, welcome to the show. First of all, congratulations. You're crushing it. But you're shifting here a little bit, right? Yep. Now, you say based on CPI, the Federal Reserve, you anticipate some different changes, so you're making changes. Before we get to what you're shifting to, what is it about this data that's making you, want to be preemptive here?
So two last CPI readings, right, came at 0.3 and 0.4. That means the annual inflation rate is now running above the 2% target rate. So that's concerning to us. We have sticky housing prices, energy costs are coming up, food away from home is coming up. So we're concerned about inflation. We think that rate cuts are going to push further towards the end of the year. And so we're moving into more profitable equities, cash flow oriented. So we are favoring cash flows, profitability, shorter duration, not extremely high growth. And we're being conservative.
I love the fact that you are looking at the data and not making excuses. No, really, honest, I hate to say it, but a lot of folks on the street do that. They'll have a thesis and they stick to it. And when the data goes against their thesis, it doesn't matter. It's an excuse. It gets cold in January, that kind of weird stuff. All right, so you're shifting toward, you want companies that are more profitable, that have cash flow. You want steady cash flow.
Yes.
Shorter duration. What does that mean?
Shorter duration, so like the long-term assets, which is usually ultra-high growth equities, we avoid this at that moment. I mean, we still hold our, the companies that we believe have a great future, but we won't add to
them. You have core long-term holdings that you'll ride through these waves, right?
But we entered very early, so it doesn't really concern us.
Right.
But right now, if we would buy, we would go to shorter duration assets.
So we just had Savita Sumarini on, and she also likes large cap names. So you like large cap, but right now, non-mega cap.
Non-mega,
But large cap.
Non-Magnificent Seven. Magnificent Seven, you know me. I love NVIDIA. In it since it was a $5 stock. But right now we are favoring other companies such as Meta. So that would be our preferred mega cap.
All right. I want you to share some ideas with us, but I got to give you a shout out. This goes back to February of last year. You gave us 14 ideas, 12 are up. I mean, you've got some grand slams here. This, I think, is which one is that? 66% up, 64%, and of course we just talked Meta up 191%. Real quick, so I can get to the ones that you like now. These names that are down slightly less, single digits. You hold on, Oracle and Palantir.
Yeah, actually, Oracle will be one of the shorter duration, not ultra-high growth, steady, slow and steady companies with great cash flow that we would favor in this market.
By the way, this Anet, I have subscribers in that. I love it as well. All right, so you say stick with the Meta.
Yes.
Spotify, I'm going to ask you a trivia question. How many artists made $1 million on Spotify last year?
Are you one of them?
I seem great in the shower, but that's about it. 1,250. That blew my mind. $1 million, right? Everyone's starting to get on the Spotify train. I have subscribers in it as well. Why do you like it?
So I like it because you like it too. I think for the same reasons. Their revenue is at an all-time high. 13% revenue growth. And I think you know that. Yesterday, they increased their subscription plan by $1 to $2 a month. So I think that will give a healthy boost to their revenues.
Right.
They have great margins. Their EBIT margins at 5%. They're cutting costs by an impressive 4.5%. It's a great company. I think in this market, they're going to become more consistently profitable.
I agree. I would only add a caveat. Maybe it's more volatile than the average stock. Hang in there. In my mind, I love this name too. I'm also in this. And it's so funny. This was the old symbol. Since they changed the symbol, the stock keeps going up. I got 30 seconds. Why do you like this one?
I love this one. It was Fleetcore, to your point. So we like it because of their margins. Again, great margins, 44% EBIT margin compared to 22% for the industry average. And they're improving their profits by $100 million a year. It's a great company in this market.
Before I let you go, yesterday Apple saying, you know what, we may mess around with the next big thing. Home robots, you in?
No.
No, that's not a buy signal? Is it a sell? It sounds desperate to me, right? They were going to be in EVs. They're like, never mind.
Exactly.
Now we're going to do robots.
It never works. When the company becomes bureaucratic, they have the arrogance thing that they can do anything, but they really can't, right? So there are smaller companies that can compete and get their market share.
Right.
So I don't think it's going to be another EV case here.
Great work.
Nice to see
you. Keep up the great work, Eva. Really killing it.